Land of frozen Himalayas and the land of mountaineers. For the local folk are frightened with the strangest kind of fears. Though it may be just a rumor, it's been talked about for years.
Snow they say they can't define. They've heard some ghostly rumblings in the horrifying way. A story guaranteed to send a shiver down your spine.
The abominable snowman. He prowls, he growls, and the tracks he leaves behind him are stupendous.
From the sound, he must be something quite tremendous.
It may be just a hoax, it may be true, it may be not. But if you should bump into him, he'll fix you on the spot.
He'll take one frozen look at you, and that will be your lot.
The abominable snowman.
No, 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 no.
Ah, that's John from the space satellite. Come in, John.
Dad, I know you've been kind of skeptical about this so-called abominable snowman, but these alarm calls from the Everest area are still coming through. Three more people have disappeared in the last 2 weeks. Don't you think it's time for a little action?
I know you're worried about this, John, but as you know, Thunderbirds only answer direct calls for help when there is definite evidence that lives are in danger. Now, these abominable snowman stories have been going around for years. Now, leave it with me, John. I'll see what I can do.
Okay, Dad. I'll let you know if I hear any more news. Over and out.
Say, Dad, Penny's over in Delhi right now. What say we give her a call and ask her to investigate?
Good idea, Scott. This should be just Penny's cup of tea. Tintin, bring me our agent's file for that area, will you? Then I'll call Penny.
Well, I must say, Parker, it was a good idea of yours to bring Fab One along. So much more convenient.
Yes, Belady. The hair conditioning is working a treat, don't you think?
In this heat, it's a jolly good thing that it is. Oh, my compact. Must be the emergency call. Lady Penelope here. Oh, hello, Jeff.
Hi, Penny. You may think this kind of strange, but we've been getting reports from the Everest area about this so-called abominable snowman, which seems to be terrorizing the local people.
Do go on, Jeff. I'm intrigued.
I thought maybe you could go up and do a little investigating.
But of course, Jeff. I'd adore to go up to the mountains. I missed winter sports this year, and I'd love to see a snowman, abominable or otherwise.
You may think I'm kidding, Penny, but you take care. This could be serious. Now, our local agent for that area is Gallup Din, and you can contact him in the village of Borapur.
F-A-B, Jeff. Agent Gallup Din at Borapur. Right. I'm on the scent, so to speak.
Oh, Lady Penelope. It is with an exaggerated sense of pleasure that I am welcoming you to Borapur. The legendary tales of your manifold exploits have preceded you post-haste, and I...
Quite, Mr. Gallup. Mr. Din. Your little plan to have our secret meeting in this tonga was quite ingenious. Such a pleasant way of traveling, a tonga.
Chugger, eh? I would mind if the horse I was steering was a thoroughbred, but for an A-class chauffeur like me, with millions of luxury motoring miles under my belt, driving a deadbeat old nag like this is a bit of a liberty. Come on, get up, get up.
Now, Mr. Dim, this abominable snowman, what evidence is there that it has been seen in the area?
Oh, my dear high-born titled English lady, the evidence is underwhelming. Clues abound in every crook and nanny. Footprints. Footprints of a huge circumference can be observed at the scene of every felony.
I see, I see. Well, I should like to go to the scene of the crime and observe these footprints for myself. Now, about a guide.
This I have already arranged with very sudden alacrity. Unfortunately, due to the very potent curse of the abominable snowman, none of the local people would dare to act in this respect. But with a resilience born of experience, I have contacted a well-known Asiatic explorer who has worked in the area for many Indian summers.
And he has agreed to act as guide. Excellent, excellent.
The gratification I feel at your remarks is overflowing. Woo, back! Woo! Dear friend, we must part. Our destination has arrived. There is the skicopter and the guide to transport you. And I advise you very strongly to change now into your warmest clothing. For not only is it very cold, but most biting of all is the wind.
I suggest we begin our search here, madam.
Out you go, Parker.
Right, m'lady. Let me help you down. Careful, m'lady. It's as hard as ice out here.
Oh. Oh, it's my ankle. I'm afraid I've twisted it.
How unfortunate, Lady Penelope.
Oh, unfortunate indeed. Oh, what on earth can we do now?
May I suggest that I take your servant to see the footsteps of the abominable snowman while you rest in the passenger compartment of the ski copter?
Well, I'm afraid I have no choice. I'm sure you'll be amenable to our guide's suggestion, won't you, Parker?
Certainly, m'lady. I'll have this diabolical snowman caper sorted out before you can say fab one.
If your servant is ready, Lady Penelope, we will proceed.
The name is Parker, if you don't mind.
Thank you, and good hunting to you both.
Here, mate. Yeah, what is this? Some sort of house cave? What are we doing in here?
Strange things happen in this part of the world. For example, have you noticed that large steel door over there? Strange, is it not? A steel door in an ice cave?
You could say that again, mate.
The door opens. Shall we go in?
Here, what's all this? Where did all these blokes come from? What's all this drilling and shoveling like?
Quiet, you fool!
Hey, what's the gun for? What's your game down here, then?
My game, you fool, is that I am the abominable snowman. Have you no imagination? I have lured you here like all the others, and now you are my slave like them. You, too, will dig and add to this ever-growing pile of priceless uranium. And I will become the richest man in the world.
You may not be the snowman, but you are certainly abominable.
Silence, you fool! I am in no mood for your insolence. I have a painful way of dealing with people like you, as you will learn when I return. But first, to deal with that meddlesome Lady Penelope. I have something special in mind for her. Do not get clever ideas, fool. When this door closes, there is no means of escape.
Cure, this is a great shambles. I better get on the blur at the Lady P. Now, where's me staff box? Ah, here we are. This is Parker calling Lady Penelope. Come in, please, Lady Penelope.
Yes, Parker. What on earth the matter? Why the emergency call?
We're in dead trouble, m'lady. Our guide's turned out to be a bit of a villain playing a double role. Not only is he our guide, but so he tells me, the abominable snowman too. I'm trapped in this air cave. You're numbered out there with a sprained ankle, and he's on his way to sort you out.
Oh dear, how inconvenient. I'd better get on to Jeff right away. Now leave everything to me, Parker. And don't worry. Over and out.
Ah, that's Penny. She's probably got some news on the abominable snowman situation.
Jeff, Penny here. We've nearly solved the riddle of the abominable snowman, but in the process, we've landed in a spot of bother. I'm afraid we need your urgent assistance.
Sure thing, Penny. Okay, on your way, Scott.
Right, Dad.
Can you give us your position, Penny?
Yes, Jeff. International map reference, 421X037.
Right, got it. Now, you just hold on as best you can. Scott will be with you in about 55 minutes.
Scott from Thunderbird 1. Ready for a liftoff.
Right. Lift off, Scott.
Changing to horizontal flight.
Base to Thunderbird 1. Penny's position is reference 421X037.
FAB, Dad. Speed 7.5 thousand miles per hour. ETA, 1805 local time.
Oh, this wretched ankle. This is such an awkward moment to be immobilized. I do hope Scott arrives before it's too late. Oh, you're back. Where's Parker?
Hey, I'm afraid, madam. I have some distressing news for you. When we were crossing a crevasse, your servant slipped. The rope holding us together snapped, and he plunged into the bowels of the earth.
Do go on.
All my Herculean efforts to rescue him were of no avail, and I fear he hath gone to an icy and eternal grave.
Your dramatic little piece of acting was almost convincing, except for one thing.
What do you mean?
Let me enlighten you. You have tried to convince me that Parker has fallen down a crevasse to his doom. But I know that although he has fallen into a trap, he is, at this moment, very much alive. You, sir, are a blackguard.
Thunderbird 1 to base.
Come in, Scott. What's your problem?
No problem, Dad. Just checking to see if there's any change in the situation.
No change. Just make it as snappy as you can. Penny's pretty smart at talking herself out of tight spots, but we don't want her to have to say too much.
You talk too much. You are completely overwrought. I insist you lie down and rest until this brainstorm is over.
I will certainly not lie down. Abominable snowman, indeed. I suspected from the first there was some sort of plot behind this. Why else do you think I agreed to investigate it?
May I suggest, to convince you beyond all doubt of my devotion to your welfare, that we fly over the crevasse where Parker met his untimely end.
And if you haven't disposed of me by then, I suppose we'll go on to have tea with the abominable snowman himself. No, my friend, we are not as stupid as you would suppose. And furthermore, I have called International Rescue. They are already on their way.
So, you have tried to outwit me. Very clever.
Keep your hands where they are. I have you covered.
Not quite, Lady Penelope. Not quite. I shouldn't try that again. Now, We're going on a little trip.
I've arrived at danger zone, but apart from some ski copter marks in the snow, there's no sign of them.
Now look, Scott, we must find Penny before she comes to any harm. Now this is what you do.
Now, Lady Penelope, how do you like my little torture chip? Every modern device.
You won't get away with this. Your kind never do.
There is no need to lose your temper. You're a little uncomfortable, perhaps. Are those straps too tight?
I may be a mere woman, but don't underestimate me.
And don't underestimate me, Lady Penelope. This little piece of machinery here will perhaps persuade you to treat me with more respect. Let me demonstrate it to you. You see that solid steel girder over there? Watch. Straight through. I'm sure you'll agree, most efficient.
Most efficient. Clearly, you are not going to all this trouble for nothing. What do you want?
Not so fast, Lady Penelope. Now, if I aim the laser beam towards you, all I have to do is to keep my finger pressed on this button, and the beam will slice through the metal girder that you are strapped to on the same height as that swan-like neck of yours. But to avoid starting this unpleasant experiment, all you have to do is give me information about the codes used by International Rescue for their secret messages. Don't be surprised, Lady Penelope. I know that you are their London agent.
Wherever you got your information, I can assure you it's quite false.
Oh, come, madam. Perhaps this will stimulate your memory. I will move the beam slowly. Now, will you tell me their secret?
Thunderbird 1 to base. But tell Brains the new metal detector works great. I've located the ski copter, and I'm going into land.
FAB, Scott.
Speak now, Lady Penelope, or you will never speak again. The beam is only 6 inches from your neck. You struggle in vain. The beam unfortunately generates a great heat. It can be rather painful before you actually lose consciousness. Only 3 inches to go.
You're wasting your time. I know nothing.
All right. You asked for it.
Okay, you've got 3 seconds to switch off that beam.
Look out, Scott. Scott, switch off the beam.
Well, where's the master switch?
Scott, quickly.
Now hold tight, Penelope. Penelope, are you okay?
Okay, Scott.
Oh, I hope you haven't been too incommoded, m'lady.
Parker.
Oh. It looks like I've arrived too late.
Heavens, how did you get here? Oh, dear, this is all so confusing. Scott, is he dead?
I only used my tranquilizer gun. He'll have a nice, quiet siesta till the airborne police arrive. Now, come on, let's get you out of here.
Oh. Oh, what a relief. And how splendid to see you back, Parker. How on earth did you escape?
I don't want to blow my own hooter, my lady, but getting out of that nick was a pushover. And knowing how that rat villain was going to sort you out, I had to take drastic action.
How resourceful of you, Parker. And how clever of you to find us, Scott. However did you do it?
A Brain's new metal detector. It can pick up a metal object from a height of 1,000 feet. And that ski copter is all metal.
Brilliant. Quite brilliant. Now, what about all those other poor people in that cave Parker escaped from? What can we do about them?
Well, he'll be taken care of when the police arrive. And when our friend here wakes up, I don't think he'll be in any condition to take on International Rescue again for quite a while.
Don't you think we ought to contact Jeff now, Scott? I'm sure he's waiting anxiously for news.
Sure thing, Lady Penelope.
That's the call we've been waiting for. Go ahead, Scott.
Oh, Jeff, Penny here. You'll be glad to know our little investigation has resolved itself satisfactorily. What started off as a light-hearted adventure turned into something quite nasty.
Yes, Dad, it's a long story. One we'll enjoy telling you when we get back.
Right, Scott. Bring Penelope and Parker back and you can tell me the whole story then. Grandma will have a nice meal waiting for you.
What an absolutely super idea, Jeff. As far as I'm concerned, the legend of the abominable snowman can be buried forever.
F.A.B.